BA.5 is more infectious than previous strains. BA.5 is another Omicron variant. It has different mutations on it, and the result of these mutations have two specific effects. So one of them is that the mutations are on a part of the spike protein that we form immunity to, and it means that if we have immunity to previous strains, that doesn't protect us as well for this strain. The other part of the mutations is that it results in increased viral replication, and that means higher virus concentrations. They can enter our cells better, and that means that also people tend to have the virus and shed it longer after they're infected. But the good news is that most of those infections now, those breakthrough infections, are generally outpatient illnesses, so they're not resulting in severe infection. Those infections result in fever, cough. It's still not pleasant to have that. You're going to miss a few days of work. You're going to miss a few days of school if you're a student. But in general, these breakthrough infections are not resulting in hospitalizations. There's some emerging evidence with every infection that you get with COVID, the more infections that you get, this results in increased risk of long-term side effects that can include strokes, heart disease, kidney disease, and other long-term problems. And this is probably due to the inflammation that occurs with each infection. And the inflammation can have widespread effects on several different organ systems. Even if you're vaccinated, even if you end up having a breakthrough infection that's mild, it's better not to have any breakthrough infections. It's better not to have these infections so that you can avoid the increased risk of these long-term side effects. COVID is not over, and people need to consider to continue to protect themselves. Even if people are vaccinated, even if people have had some immunity from infection previously with other strains, you can still get breakthrough infections. So I do encourage people to be fully up to date for all vaccine doses for which they're eligible for, including the boosters, and to continue to mask when you're indoors, especially around people who are outside of your normal household. So when you're shopping, if you're going to any indoor event, I do encourage people to continue to mask.